Do you desire to learn about the process for designing a cloud architecture or an enterprise architecture? If so, this video is for you. This video is part of a series on the cloud architecture process and the enterprise architecture process. In this video, we will continue to discuss the cloud architecture process. Specifically, we will be introducing Phase C of the TOGAF Enterprise Architecture Framework. Phase C is all about developing the data architecture. We like the TOGAF framework as it provides a structured and repeatable approach to designing cloud and enterprise architectures that drive digital transformation. We also like the TOGAF framework as it's an industry standard, which is used by major players like IBM, Microsoft, Cisco, Dell, Intel, VMware, Accenture, Deloitte, and everyone who's everyone in designing cloud and enterprise architectures. After developing the business architecture, the next phase of the enterprise architecture process really begins with developing the data architecture. If you haven't seen the video on developing an architecture vision or developing the business architecture, you can find them in the description of this video. Make sure to watch our other videos that cover the TOGAF framework. Developing the data architecture is phase C of the TOGAF Enterprise Architecture Framework. In today's world, the data architecture is critical for modern business. With modern data pipelines and artificial intelligence, data is becoming an even greater asset to the enterprise. So, what is data architecture? Data architecture describes how the data is managed. This includes data collection, transformation, distribution, and consumption. Data architecture sets the blueprint for data and the way it flows in and through the storage systems. Some key components of the data architecture are data models. Data models describe how the data is collected, used, stored, and the relationships between different types of data. Data flow is really about understanding how data moves through an organization's systems, including how it's created, processed, and ultimately archived or deleted. Data warehouses and databases. You can think of them as storage systems where the data is actually going to be stored. Data lakes. Data lakes are storage repositories that can store vast amounts of raw data in native format until it's needed later. Data governance. Now, data governance is the management of data availability, usability, consistency, data integrity, and data security. You can think of it as including a set of processes, roles, policies, and metrics to ensure the effective and efficient use of information. Of course, we have ETL processes. ETL stands for extract, transform, and load. It's the process of taking data from one system and transforming it into a usable format and then loading it into another system. Data security. Now, this is going to involve measures and technologies to protect sensitive data from unauthorized access, breaches, or theft. Now, there's also going to be metadata. Now, metadata is really data about the data, which provides information about the content, quality, condition, or other characteristics of the data. And of course, data and its integration between business processes. Data architecture should align with business goals, supporting business operations, analysis, and decisions throughout the organization. Now that we have defined the data architecture, we must first baseline the current data architecture. What is the current data architecture? How is the current data architecture working? What's working with the current data architecture and what's not working? How is the current data architecture supporting the enterprise's needs? Next, we need to develop the future data architecture. The future data architecture is based upon the architecture vision and the new target business architecture. Remember, the data and future technical architectures are all about supporting the enterprise's business initiatives. Next, we need to perform a gap analysis. We need to find the difference between the current data architecture and the target or to be future data architecture. Now we're going to need to evaluate all options to go from the current architecture to, of course, the future architecture. We're going to need to evaluate the trade-offs between our architectural choices. This is critical, as almost every architectural decision will have an impact on the business. And we need to pick the options that are going to be best for the business. We then need to confirm that the plan to go from the current architecture to the future architecture supports all business goals and requirements. Next, we need to conduct a formal stakeholder review of the new data architecture. Now, stakeholders are individuals who have a vested interest in the organization, its success, and its decision-making. And we need to confirm that the new data architecture satisfies all stakeholder requirements. Please note that architectural choices may help one part of the organization but place new challenges or burdens on an additional part of the organization. So we most likely, as cloud architects or enterprise architects, will have to get involved in some negotiation between stakeholders to get to the final solution. Next, we will need to get buy-in from all the stakeholders so they will support the architectural changes when they're ultimately implemented. Lastly, we need to finalize the data architecture. We need to fully document the data architecture. We will need to document every building block of the data architecture, and we will then need to store the documents in the architecture repository. Again, the architecture repository is where all critical architectural documents are to be stored. Now you know phase C of the TOGAF Enterprise Architecture Framework, developing the data architecture. Of course, this is a high-level overview, and if you'd like to have a deeper understanding of this content, make sure to look at our training content. The link for our training is in the description of this video. Now to learn how to get your first cloud architect job, please download the free ebook. The link is in the description of this video. And please join us for that free webinar on how to become the ultimate cloud architect. It's also free, and the link for that is in the description of this video. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please give it a like, and please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to help you in your cloud architect or enterprise architect career. Look forward to seeing you in another video. Take care.